Hey guys, welcome back. So this is the continuations of Stream API, and here I will talk about grouping by, right? We'll try to understand how grouping by will help us. So remember in the last video I was saying that once the grouping by chapter I will start all together, I will cover all the concepts. So this is the one where I'm going to discuss. So basically the grouping by, what it will do is, the name itself says that it will group your data. It will group your list of stream and it will give you map as an output. Okay, so your list will get converted to the map. And how it works is, so you know that on the list you can call dot stream, and here when you call dot stream, here what output you will get? You will get a stream of a string, right? That's what you will get till here. Then you are calling that dot collect. Okay, so collect method, you know that it will collect the data based on the collectors what you have inside the collect, right? Now collectors, basically if you look at, so this collector, so let me write one and let me show you so that you will have more confidence. I designed this in a day so that, you know, I can, while explaining, I can take more time to explain. So you can see that list.stream. So look at here, what is the return type? A stream of a string, right? Then dot collect. So collect, what is the return type? It's a stream. You can see that collect return type is the stream. So click on collect. Now inside the collect, it will take collectors. Guys, focus here. Collectors, you need to select this one. Java util stream package one, okay? So select this collectors, and then this collectors has a method called grouping by. So there are a couple of methods. Grouping by, three overloaded method, and then grouping by concurrent. I will cover all the methods. Okay, so first we will focus on the first one, grouping by, where it requires function as an input. So just do grouping by, control space bar. So grouping by, if you press control and click on this grouping by, if you go inside, basically it requires a function. Okay, like how do you want to group them, right? And this grouping by, the output, whatever you will get a map. Okay, you will get a map, you will get key value pair. You can see that your output will come as a key value pair. So just go back. Now since it takes a function, okay, same thing I am doing here, dot collect grouping by. What I am trying to do here is, I am changing the string to the length, like I want to group them by the length of the string. Okay, so basically I need a map where whatever a string has the same length, okay, it will be considered as a list, and the key is going to be the length of the string. So when you actually do grouping by, so how it works is, in this it will run a loop because you have a stream, and it will count the length of the string. Okay, so apple has 5 length, 2 apple, papaya has 6, banana also has length 6, orange also has length 6. So basically if you look at, this is going to be a key, right? And the value is going to be the list of data. That is the reason, if I will delete this return type of this grouping by, when you place mouse over and click on create local variable, automatic you will get object and list of a string. So the object is nothing but, through which object is the key. And why the value is list of a string, guys? The reason is very simple. Why the value is list of a string? Because when you are trying to group based on the length, right, there are a couple of a string which has the same length. So that will be considered as a list of a string, which is the value, and the key, which is nothing but the length, is going to be a key, right? So this is one way of doing that. Now the second, if you look at, I will run that and I will explain you also. Second one, again on the list I'm calling the stream, and then I'm doing that dot collect collectors. So again collectors, guys, always focus one thing, you know, you need to make sure that what package need to be imported. Sometimes what happens, by mistake we import some other package and we'll end up with not getting the right expected result. Okay, so package is very important. This collectors should come from Java util stream. Now look at here I did a stream dot collect collectors dot grouping by, and then I want to group them which has contents O, okay, which has contents of, which means I want to group them by the boolean, right? Like whatever true will be the one key and the false will be the one key, because either I will have contents O or I don't have. So the key is going to be the boolean, okay, and the value is going to be the list of a string. Now let's run that. Your all confusion, even whatever confusion you have, let's say 1 or 2% in your mind running now, it will get clear by looking the output, okay. See, look at here guys, focus on the first one. It's a map, right, as I said. And whatever I said, it worked in the same way. So when you are doing that grouping by length, so when the length is 5, right, how many string has the same length? 2 string, apple comma apple. So the 2 list has the same string, then 6. So 6 is the key and value is what? Value is papaya, banana, orange, orange, orange. So now you can understand how this works. So whatever you do grouping by, that will act like a key, and the value is going to be the outcome from this. So whatever length will match, that string will be considered as a value. If you look at the second one, since it is a contents, which means key is going to be a boolean, so it's a false. So these are the string which has no contents O, so it's false. False is the key, this is the value, and this is again true, and this is the value. So actually this is very useful, guys. Sometimes we have a list and we need to convert to the map based on certain conditions. This grouping by will help you a lot, and I hope that you understood this, because this is a simple thing. By looking the output, it made you very, very clear that how it works. So let me copy this output. I will paste it in this class itself, so that when you guys refer this code, you should not get any problem. Okay, this is the output, guys. Right? This is the output. You can understand by looking the output also. Output. So I need to comment this. Yeah. Go to the second example, guys. Second example, if you look at, I have a list, okay, which takes double data. I'm running a loop and I'm adding some data to the list, right? Then, as I said, group by has couple of overloaded methods. So here I'm going to use the second method, okay? The second method, what it takes is, just press control, click on group by. Second method will take a function and collector, okay? It's a classifier and downstream, right? So function and collector. Guys, one more thing, my small suggestion is, whenever you have this code handy, okay, you please go through Java documentation also. It will give you a lot of confidence, right? It will give you a lot of confidence, because concept wise I will teach you everything, but sometimes you should also read the Java documentations to have the vast knowledge, okay? So when you do grouping by, it takes function, again if I'll go inside that, it takes a function and collector. So one is the function which will which will have a return type, and then collector which will collect the data, right? So look at here, I am doing that functions.identity, okay? So when you say functions.identity, it will return the same function, which means whatever data your list has, when you say functions.identity, it will return double function, right? It will just return the double functions. So how this works is, one by one your double data from this list will get assigned here, and then I'm doing that comma collectors dot counting, because my second argument should be collector. You can see that my second argument should be the collectors, so I want to count that. Simple example I have, I want to count that, and what output I will get? Output I will get a map, because your grouping by will always give you output as a map. So your list will get converted to the map, and if you look at here, it's a double comma long, because what happens when you say collectors dot counting, the return type is the long here, okay? Return. So how this works is, one by one it will fetch the data from here, it will fetch the data from here, and since identity is the double, so this double will get counted. Now if I will run that, you will understand. So you can see that your all data, whatever you have imported, right? So what is the identity? This is the key. And what is the value? Value is the counting. So here, identity is going to be your key, and the value is the counting, right? You can see that all counting is 111, because there was no repeated data, right? Now I will do one thing. I will just, you know, I will add 2 times. So now we should have the repeated data. Now let's run this. Now if you run this, you can see that your value is going to be 2 now, like counting is 2, right? This is your identity, which is nothing but the data, the double data your list has, and here is the counting, right? You can understand. So how your list got converted to the map, and you are able to count the value what your list has, and it successfully got converted to the map, right? So sometimes we do get a requirement where you have a list of data and you need to convert into a map, and let's say you want to count some data, like what is the common data or what is common object, right? So you can use that grouping by. I will tell you one example which you might correlate with your project example in example number. I mean, going forward, in example number 3rd or 4th, I'll be using that. Not 3rd, in 4th, I'll be using that. Okay. So look at here, the 3rd example. Here I have list of a string, right? And I've added some string. And you can see that since it is the list, I am allowed to add duplicate data. So I have added it, right? Now I am calling that list.stream. Okay. And I'm doing that dot collect. So collect the data based on the collector. This is my collectors. So collectors, again, it comes from Java util stream package. Guys, remember this. So when you say grouping by, I'm saying that identity. So what is my identity here? Identity is my string. These are the strings. These are my identity. And the same identity, I want to count that, like how many times the same identity got repeated. Okay, and then it will get converted to the map. So you know that when you say counting, the return type is the long. So press control, click on counting. You can see that internally it counts this counting. You can see that this is the method, right? Why I'm saying that return type is the long? Internally it returns reducings, and you can see that long and sum. So it internally, you know, it will do some summation and it will give you the output. So your return type is going to be the long. Let's say you don't need to remember that, right? If I will delete this also, and when I place mouse over here and click on create local variable, automatic will go a string and long, right? So either string and object, both are fine. So why long? Because of this counting. Okay, so your this data will get converted to the map, and your identity, so grouping by functions dot identity, so your identity will get converted to a map and it will get counted. So again, press control, go to the grouping by. Your first one is the function and your second one is the collector. Got it? Now let's say run this program. See, you can see that apple is called apple 2 times is repeated in your list. Papaya is repeated 1 time. Orange repeated 3 times. Banana repeated 1 time. So you can see that your list got converted to the map, and the key is nothing but your string, and the value is nothing but how many times it got repeated. So this is helping you to know, like, how many apples you have, how many papaya you have, orange you have, and banana you have in your list, right? So that's how it will help you a lot. One more thing, you'll be wondering, instead of functions, I'm writing that functions.identity, because when you press control, click on identity, you can, if you'll go inside this identity, you can see that it returns the function, okay? It returns the same functions, whatever your identity has. So what I'm trying to say that is, instead of writing this identity, let me write one function here and then let me show you. So what I need is, I have a function which takes a string data, okay, which also returns the string data, because function, you know that it has a method which will process your record, right? So let's say it takes a string data. And what I'm saying that return me the same string. I don't want to do anything. So click on the function, go inside that. It has apply. So apply, what it will return? Whatever object you have, the second object it will return. So either you write functions.identity, or you can copy these things, and instead of functions.identity, if you'll go and replace it, both works well. Okay. Both works well. Just I wanted to explain you. You can see that your output remains same. It is not going to change. Or you copy functions from here. You can design outside also. And just place the function here. even in that case your output is not going to change guys, it remains same, right? In my next video I will continue with this grouping by concept. Thank you guys, thank you for watching this.